All right, it's Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You know the drill. Let's get right down to it. And now the offense getting set. First and 10. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Over the middle, that's caught by Rice. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's got it. Got his man on the end round. Complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Rice. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. And that does it for this one. Pat yourself on the back. You just completed and dominated the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge.
Welcome in, everyone, to another edition of the NFL and Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
And now the offense will look to convert on third down.
Here we go now. Green.
They'll look to throw here. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. They got 29 yards there. And it'll be a New York first. Now they'll run on the draw. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. A gain of 3, second down.
Here we go now.
Back to throw here. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Fast footwork by Sanders. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. They'll look to throw now on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the... And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Jerry Rice, his second touchdown of the night. And the Jets have made this a one-score game.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the book.
Yeah. You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
Here's Franks now to kick this one away. Adoree Jackson on the return. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard at the 41-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it, and let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. Following the penalty, it's Murray. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key 3rd down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key 3rd down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Play fake to Murray. Now Mariota. And he's got some space here. It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
On first down, Murray. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. Second down following the run. They'll
running left side with Murray. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause of the action. A timeout here defensively. The Titans on third down. Can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Handoff. It's Murray. And an alley to run. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. So a defensive timeout. Chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. Now Mariota. And he locates Walker. Complete. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a 1st down.
Partner, you got to like what they're doing right there. Little by little, they're getting closer. Another good pickup.
Now a give. This is Murray. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around a training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
sports coverage of the NFL is on the air.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken about the 12. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. Here come the Jets now as they get set to go on first down. And now running right through it. Sanders shaking and baking. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Jerry Rice, open right side. The 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Jerry Rice, 49 yards. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead. And that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
He's got it, and the Jets lead 7-0. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. On the return, Jabril Peppers. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. They go play action here on first down. His throw incomplete. David Njoku was the intended receiver, and it's second down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field,
trying for right, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Major Wright, and they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
I know some teams are leery about playing cover two because a strong safety's not usually a terrific cover guy. But in this case, he played it perfectly. Read the football and went and made the interception.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Rice. 23 yards on the play. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll look to throw here on first down. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. There as he runs into a brick wall. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12.
Offside defense.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that flag was coming.
Yeah, offside's easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
He'll drop to throw. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the 8. Caleb Brantley able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of 5. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him 2 touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on fourth down, that's big for the defense.
So the drive takes them inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
Now it's Franks following the made field goal to send it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. Cody Kessler trotting back onto the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense. I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number 2. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. From the gun, it's Kessler. And a catch made by Kenny Brand. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8, but it also lead to a fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
Colquitt on to kick as he sends it away. Now Sanders. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Jets will take over first and 10. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's played a pretty clean first half. A touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Flushed out right. And some space here. Room to run past midfield. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Jets move the chains.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. Back now as I search for my cue card here. There we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And all the way in, touchdown, New York. A big play there, 49 yards. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-snap?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
He's got it, and it's 17-0. So they only needed three plays on that drive, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field.
This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
He was looking to get it to Kenny Britt that time. That'll bring up second down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Kessler now to throw. Powers ahead at the 45.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what?
And oh, his first carry. He loses the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Well, he's not the starter coming in getting his first carry off the bench. That's not the way to earn more carries.
You have to stay in the game, even if you're not on the field, right? Stay mentally sharp, stay ready. And above all, when you get into the game, hold on to the football. Don't let the other team have it.
And snapped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. They'll set up to throw. Rolling to his right. Floats one there, incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's got to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be.
Back to throw. This is caught, Gronkowski. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. They'll look to throw on third and goal. And this is going to be incomplete.
This goes to the goal line. You got to be very careful with the offense calls rub routes. When I call a pick trying to screen you off from your coverage, does a nice job of avoiding that and helping force an incompletion.
And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the 3. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That's caught. It's Gronkowski for a Jets touchdown. Rob Gronkowski from 3 yards out, and the Jets are going to add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. And the lead is now 24. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. We get a glance at Duke Johnson as he heads back out onto the field. You can count his carries on one finger. They've only given him the rock one time, Charles. What gives?
So we can't draw any conclusions just yet. He has to touch the ball multiple times in order to get into a rhythm, and have a chance to have success. You know who else gets into a rhythm? The offensive line. They feel better about what they're doing when they know they've had multiple opportunities to get it done.
Yeah, well, the conclusion we draw so far, they're losing here in the second quarter. Let's see if they change tunes. Now Kessler on second down. To the right side and complete to Njoku. That catch good for five. It's third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
On third and two, Kessler looks to throw. He's got his tight end in Njoku. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Let's go! Boom,
on first and 10, it's Kessler. Throw left side, caught by the tight end in Njoku. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Kessler. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
I tell you, Brandon, this defensive player was in confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Let's go. 3-19.
Kessler now on third down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
Kessler now on first down. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down.
That's a nice catch, but unable to stay in bounds. And remember, it wasn't a wide receiver who works on that all the time.
I was going to say, he likes to get the ball handed to him. Now, don't get me wrong, he's part of the passing game as well, but maybe a little out of his comfort zone there.
Yeah, he might want to have a few words to say to us about that later, but I am still going with you on that one. Wide receivers work out a little bit more.
Now, he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution, or do they think they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out.
All right, here we go. Green.
Kessler will try again on second down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
And I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule where the offensive player fumbles the ball, it goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not their friend.
Yeah, exactly right. I actually played for a guy in college. You know what he used to name the sideline? Sammy. Sammy sideline, and use him well.
And a nice gain of 21 yards.
For many teams, the evaluation of tight ends has really changed. We used to wonder about how they would block first and foremost. Now we want to know how these guys can run because we envision them in offenses, catch the ball. How much yardage can they gain after that?
And that on to display there for a good pickup.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
What a job by this defense all game long. They've come together and really said, no one's crossing our goal line, and they're definitely not going to start right now.
You can just see the dejection. Feel like nothing is working offensively.
Hurry up, here we go. Green 39, green 39.
Second and 10, here's Kessler again. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
Here we go now.
On third and long, it's Kessler. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 and the 36. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the... So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he's running right through it. So he got three and one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Hurry up, here we go.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down.
Let's go.
Looking to throw. Looking middle. It's caught by Gronkowski. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up fourth down. They'll look to throw again. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, You don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and look like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. They'll look to throw here. Throwing left side, he's got Gronk, complete. Give him nine there on the first down completion. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Then he'll give it here to his running back. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
Flush to his right. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because it certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks nowhere to go here. He lost the football. They've got this big lead. They said, forget one. We want two. Instead, they got zero.
Unbelievable they didn't even attempt it from the 15-yard line. What are they thinking? I do know this. When you fake one in this situation with that type of a lead, especially from the 15-yard line, oh, boy. I tell you what, meeting them again somewhere down the line, they'll remember this. Yeah, they'll think that they were trying to clown them a little bit. Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Now Kessler on first down. Caught here left side by Brett. And he gets it down to the 32. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. To throw again is Kessler. And this is incomplete. He was trying to get it to his tight end, David Njoku. And it's third and short. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
And he comes back with one complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as he'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. Into the red zone now. It's Kessler. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. He'll get a couple yards on that one, and that'll make this a second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. The Browns on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This time they face a 3rd and 2.
Looking to throw, Kessler. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
And that one is incomplete, and now we're inside of 10 seconds. Just 9 remain. And one of the whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. And not great starting field position here for the offense.
Here we go now.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And they're going to get this one all the way up to the 35-yard line. Oh, wait, hold everything. A timeout has been called. Seemingly silly with 1 second remaining in this game. Throw now on first down. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero. Zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team, there's a lot of pride.
Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Ultimate Team.
And the Giants on first and 10, their offense ready to go. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Back to throw. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Evan Engram, the tight end. And it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but I look like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Another big shot dodge there defensively. Now they're just one more incompletion away from salting away this victory. And I know this feeling. They're almost giddy, but they have to stay focused and locked in. They can make one big mistake and throw it all away.
He's back to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40.
That one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
Let's go!
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
Hurry up, here we go.
He'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. His throw caught right around the six. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
Here we go now.
On play action, they'll throw. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's got it. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down at the 1-yard line. It's a gain of 14 there, and that should be enough to get him home free. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
The Jets, with victory seemingly in hand, they take a knee. A lot of scoring, there's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know, people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11.
welcome in, everybody, to another edition of the NFL.
Now the Colts offense ready here for first and 10. Back to throw. A dump off here for Gore. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll be a second down. Now Luck says let's get going as he'll hustle him to the line. Luck. And his throw is incomplete. Kamar Aiken, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Now what? And the reception made by Dante Moncrief. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Luck connecting with Moncrief for the Indianapolis first. Luck now to throw. And complete to Moncrief over the middle. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Now it's Luck. Throw left side complete. It's Doyle. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Luck fighting his emerging tight end Doyle for a Colt first. And with the clock ticking under 50 seconds now, he spikes it. Ten yards still left on second down. Again, Luck. Smith catches left side. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Throwing again is Luck. Now a desperation throw deep down, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Able to get there and pick it.
Nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. The Jets, with victory seemingly in hand, they take the knee. Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball park.
I'm Larry Ridley in Orlando. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
And the offense readies for a first down and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down. Back to throw here. Jerry Rice, open right side. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A good pick up there of 20 yards. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
He'll look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And down inside the 15 he goes. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Quarterbacking 101, never force the ball into double coverage, especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Dancing to his left. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. 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 I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
And this is caught, and it's a three-point game. So that effort gives him a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage, at least give your team a fighting chance.
This will be fielded at the 8. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team. And now out comes Houston. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you get a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Well, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Right, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player, not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. On third down, it's Sanders. And after the nice stiff arm, the next wave swarms in quickly for the stop. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1.
But a good play is made on defense. Oftentimes, leverage is the key to everything. Defensive line not getting turned. All the other guys making sure they're in the right spot. And on that play, they were able to stop them short of a first down.
A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
everybody. Clara Ridley welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. It's the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, we've got a good one in store.
Getting ready is the kicker, Andrew Franks. And off we go from Sports Authority Field. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And the Broncos getting ready to go on 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. And his first pass is incomplete. C.J. Anderson, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. A play fake to Anderson. It's Simeon. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Here we go. Green, 39.
Throwing on third down, Simeon. And caught, right side, Green. They stop him after a gain of only 4, and that brings up fourth down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up fourth down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3-and-out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure they didn't give up much run after catch.
So dangerous with a football in his hands. Call that a return of 38. And the Jets will have a short field to work with as they take over first and 10. And a great spot to start this drive from here. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He rifles one that's intercepted. And how about this? It's the other Brandon Marshall that picks it off. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
Anderson. He takes this from the 30 to the 34. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. A shotgun snap for Simeon. And that's complete to the tight end, Heuerman. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. It goes as a gain of 8 that moves the chains.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Hey, here we go.
First down. Here's the run with Anderson. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Let's go. Green, 35.
On second down, Anderson. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their...
Now Simeon stripped. He lost the football. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
And Sanders now to return. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. 9 yards is the pickup. Up there, and they'll have a second and one.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking.
With Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number two here. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Now back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And some room to roam now. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 10 yards is the pickup. Good enough for a Jet first down.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. They'll get 6 on the play, and it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. Back to Denver right after this. Don't forget, coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Larry Ridley. Larry will have the highlights of this first half, but he won't have touchdowns because we haven't had any to this point.
But there's still time, though, partner.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
They're going to look to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. So on fourth down, out comes the field goal unit for Todd Bowles. This will be a 34-yard attempt. And Frank's kick is good. And the Jets hit the board first. It's 3-0. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
This one taken just inside the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And coming out now, the Broncos.
And this is their third drive. Maybe the focus right now, not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that first one up?
Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. From the gun, here's Simeon. Throwing right side, that's complete. Demaryius Thomas. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Simeon finding Thomas there to give the Broncos a first down.
to throw with Simeon.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Carlos Dunlap in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight. To throw on second is Simeon. And he hits his man on the out route, Demaryius Thomas. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one.
Let's go! Green 39! Green!
From the gun on third, Simeon. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The New York set to take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. The first down screen pass, good for five.
Here we go now.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Looking deep for Demaryius. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. Oh, Thomas unable to reel that one in. And it's third and five.
I'm every offensive coordinator. Every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race, and he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And they extend their lead, a little added cushion into the lockers. What a way to finish.
Tremendous way. That's momentum that they carry in with them. Can they convert it and bring it back out to start the third quarter?
It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
Well, Larry, I know it's late there in Orlando. This is a school night. Folks eager to get right back to the action here in the third quarter. This is taken at his four. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Here's the Jet offense now. They head out to take over. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. He'll drop the throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. They'll look to throw here on first down. Over the middle, that's caught by Rice. And he's going to be taken down deep into Bronco territory. They give him a gain of 38.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Being chased out left. And I think think the ball's out. It's picked up by the Broncos.
Let's be frank, you hate the fumble at the end of the play, but prior to that, I liked a lot of what was going on. Tucks it down, takes off, picks up good yardage. But in that portion of the field, that close to the sideline,
step out.
Yeah, either get down or get out of bounds. Take care of the ball.
Yeah, he had the yards, but then the mistake. And space opens a bit as he gets it across the 15 to the 17-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
And they went for a big play through the air on second down, couldn't connect. Now it's third. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty down?
He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Chris Baker able to drop him for a loss of 2, and that'll bring up fourth down.
You and I both know we're into a whole new realm of football because we're not just looking at tendencies anymore. We're looking at analytics, and I've got to think the analytics on 3rd and 1 say run the football.
Let's take it inside his own 40. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a 1st and 10 on the short side of the field. The New York set to take the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone off.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shane Ray from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8.
You know, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz call and you still cover the screen, that allows your blitzers to get there. It seemed like the situation was 2nd and a mile to go for a 1st down. The screen's what? Throw the football. You got to pass in order to try and pick up that kind of yardage. But in this case, they ran a tendency breaker because the tendency is for defenses to be out there and be set up for a pass. So you break tendency and actually run the football. That changes everything because if you're able to find a crease, you often have big.
Welcome back now to Denver. It's Jet football as they've got the lead here, and we get set to begin quarter number 4. Play action here on 1st down. And he fires one incomplete. Looking to go back to Thomas again. And now it's 2nd down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Going for his running back, and he's got it complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
Here we go now.
Back to throw again. Got a man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Yeah, he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
Now Franks for the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
So the Broncos coming out now. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
When we talk with people about what we think the most important quality for an NFL quarterback to possess, what do people usually say?
Arm strength, and he showed the arm strength there.
Yeah, pretty good bullet passing throw, but he wasn't accurate, was he?
No.
Listen, you like mobility, but accuracy, first and foremost, is what a quarterback needs. He didn't possess it on that play.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Simeon. That's caught right side by Anderson. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Play fake to Anderson. Now Simeon. And he will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. And on second and 10 now. Throwing again is Simeon, and he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first, and it's third down now.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. Again, Simeon. But he will have a man, Demaryius Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. Here's Simeon, looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. To the air again, Simeon. Throw here is incomplete. Virgil Green is tied in the intended receiver, and it's third down. The Broncos on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 7. Simeon throwing again. Got a man. He finds Sanders. But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. A first down as it's Simeon with a hookup to Sanders. Here's Simeon. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down. It's been that kind of a day so far throwing the football. It just seems like nothing going right offensively.
Yeah, it's a catch that should have been made, pure and simple. And look, everything else that goes into running a good pass route, throw it all out if you don't catch the ball.
Been that kind of game throwing the football. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Chris Baker in there to get him for his second sack of the night. 3rd and 1. It's Simeon. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there. Hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all of that yardage. That would be a big play.
And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And it would appear the Jets are going to win this football game. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
And now look at him go. Past the 20. And he cuts left, and he's got an alley. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. A great play there. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points from me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff. Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
They start the drive with Anderson. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. They run it again with Anderson. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. The Broncos on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is third down and 12.
Here we go now. Screen three.
Out of the gun, Simeon. The Jets pressure too much as down he goes. And now with 6 seconds remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout. Here's Riley Dixon now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Taken in at the 22. Nice stiff arm.
Underused, but still effective.
And he is finally out of bounds all the way down at the 30. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number 0. Zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team.